Hey everybody, this is Michael coming to you with another episode on the Sports Card Hustle Channel, where we are going to talk to you today about the top five. That's right, we're going back to the number five. We're going to talk to you about the top five most valuable Sammy Sosa cards today. Being that a lot of his cards aren't going for astronomical prices, we figured it was best to only cover five cards today. But before we get into the video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up and subscribe down below, because it really helps me out with the YouTube algorithm and lets other sports card collectors, other sports card investors, and Sammy Sosa fans know that this video is for each and every one of them too. We are going to slide right into the list today. I hope you guys enjoy it, because I thoroughly enjoyed doing the research and making it for each and every one of you. All right, now coming to us in the number five spot today is the 1989 Grand Slam Sammy Sosa Tulsa Drillers card. Now, this is a very unique card because it is the only card on today's list that is from his minor league years. And I'm sure a lot of you probably have never even heard of Tulsa, but fun fact, it is in Oklahoma. Now you know. This card has a PSA 10 population of 24 and recently sold for $249.95. Now, one of these sold and one is still available. So if you're watching this video, you still might be able to head on over to eBay and purchase this card before it's too late. It's my favorite card on the list because it is from his minor league days, making it a very unique entry into today's most valuable Sammy Sosa cards. Now, coming to us in the fourth spot today is the 1990 Upper Deck Sammy Sosa Star Rookie card. Now, right off the bat, I think to myself, maybe mustaches will one day come back. And this is a very, very vintage looking card. This card has 1964 in existence at a PSA 10 and recently sold for $249.99. Now, three of these sold recently. One is still available. So again, like the number five card on today's list, the number fourth spot is a card that you might be able to head on over eBay right now and still pick up for $249.99. Now, rolling right into the number three position today, we have the 1990 Leaf Sammy Sosa card. Now, this card is not rare by any means when it comes to a PSA 10, because this card specifically has 1,695 of these in existence and recently sold for a not too shabby $380 on May 16th, 2020. All right, now rolling right into the number two spot, we have the 1989 Don Russ Sammy Sosa Baseball's Best card. Now, this card again displays his iconic mustache from back in the early days, and there is 230 of these cards in existence at a PSA 10, helping it sell for $405 on May 17th, 2020. All right, we are rolling right into the number one spot today, and you know what that means if you've been watching this most valuable series lately. It is time to cue the drum roll. The number one most valuable Sammy Sosa card is the 1990 Topps Tiffany Sammy Sosa baseball card. Now, this card is from the Topps Tiffany set, which is one of the most valuable Frank Thomas cards, one of the most valuable Mark McGwire cards, and so on and so forth. And it is one of the iconic sets from back in the late 80s, early 90s when it comes to baseball. This card has 155 of them in existence at a PSA 10 and recently sold on May the 17th, 2020 for $765 $2.65. Making it the most valuable Sammy Sosa card on today's list and one of the most iconic baseball cards of 1990. Now, I hope you guys enjoyed this video specifically. I know with the upcoming Mark McGwire documentary, Sammy Sosa cards might continue to climb. So be on the lookout for that because he is a big part of Mark McGwire's history, especially when it comes to the home run race. I remember growing up as a kid and I intimately remember that iconic year in baseball when they were consistently just hitting home run after home run. Mark McGwire would take the lead, then Sammy Sosa would a week later, then a couple days after that, Mark McGwire would take the lead back, and so on and so forth until Mark McGwire set the single season home run record, leaving Sammy Sosa in his dust. But that doesn't mean that Sammy Sosa's cards will not continue to climb with this upcoming documentary. So be on the lookout for that. They may climb a little bit more, so we might have to revisit the most valuable Sammy Sosa cards in the future. Hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, give it a big thumbs up. Subscribe down below. Really helps me out with the YouTube algorithm. Like I said, it lets other sports card collectors, other sports card investors, and people that just want to learn about baseball cards and Sammy Sosa fans alike know that this video is for each and every one of them too. Make sure you do that for me. Thumb it up. Subscribe down below. I will be back with another video very, very soon. So in the meantime, my friends, stay safe, stay healthy, stay blessed. And until next time, peace.